Hello and welcome back to Pandemic Playground with Dave. We are back with building a asteroid station, and today it's the welding episode you didn't ask for. So let's get started.
Thank you.
All right. So much of today's episode is welding up the ceiling. So we put our projection. I'm surprised that the projection we have right here was enough to cover all the ceilings from that side to this side to that side. And we covered as much as we could on the ceiling. We could go a little bit further on this side. Didn't realize that as well, but we went as far as this side. I'm contemplating, I don't want to make it too squared off, meaning like have this outside like this. Kind of want to mix and match it to the asteroid. It's similar to, like I said last time, assimilating to the asteroid. So maybe I have to cut this part down a little bit to match the asteroid on the outside. And then I'll put like the hangar doors a little bit closer in the inside once we have all the walls designed out and everything like that. But here we have, this is kind of what I was thinking of assimilating the asteroid. It's very jagged right now, but eventually I'm going to add in like the curved blocks and everything like that to kind of situate these things to make it smoother. But that's kind of how I want to loop around it. So here's an entrance, and then I want to loop it around to the other entrance, similar to that way. And this one is a little bit better, where it's all curved out from the asteroid a little bit, without the door, and being very squared or rectangular. But I'm going to have to stretch it out all the way around to this entrance, which is the main entrance. So we can kind of assimilate to the asteroid. So this one has the curves here, or the slope blocks, so that's why it looks a little bit smoother. So I'm going to end up doing that and wrap around the whole entire thing on the sides. Should I wrap it around vertically? Potentially. I'll probably end up doing that eventually, but not yet. But yeah, that was the plan today. Today was welding up the whole entire ceiling as much as possible. It took a very long time to do, to be honest, but it was still fun to do as well. And then of course, the next thing we did was design a wall. This is our wall decoration, or the style that we're gonna go with. So basically, we went with, on the corner ones, we did this inset wall diagonal, more of a newer block, the newest update in DLC, which is pretty cool because it has these little rails and everything like that, so you can hold on to it. Not literally, but in a sense you can. And it also has one with the light, so this is the inset wall light, so we can make the lighting down here in this tunnel a lot brighter than it is without any lights. As you see here, it's all dark until the sun hits one of the entrances, but this is an inset wall light, one after another. So you skip one, and so forth. And then there was another design too that they had, which is this one here, the inset wall pillar, which has this little box here that says caution, I guess, and a little button, not an actual usable button, but this adds a little more design to it. But I only use this closer to the corner wall. So it's only light and then this pillar, and then it's light again, and then I put this inset wall. So it's more or less a non-button like thingy there. So I just did inset wall with the light all the way down the line, all the way here. I should have put one of those pillar ones here, but decided against it because I wasn't too sure if that was the end of the tunnel with the and where we're going to add the door. I mean, it looks like that probably is the case because of right there. But haven't done that, decide yet on that. And then in the inside here, we have these half windows for design. And I flipped it over where the shaded part is on the other side, right here. So that way we can have some light come in from those inset lights. Although I'm not even sure if it makes a big difference or not, which whether it's facing this way or the other way, but it looks like it does make a minor difference. And plus we can actually see the lights here, rather than seeing a darker version of the lights like this. So these are all the lighting here with these inset lights. And this is a narrow doorway. So we just add this here just so we can walk in here for no apparent reason. And we can see through the windows and everything like that. So it's just an added effect there where we could just kind of go through it from there. I guess it could be like some kind of escape hatch type of thing. I don't know, but it is something I just put there just so we can just walk around in. And who knows, maybe I'll drill through here to make some kind of station or something inside. I mean, we could actually do that. We could put like a cryo bay or something like that right in here instead of being out in the open in these areas. So that is a potential idea that we can go with. But for now, it's just lighting effects, basically. So this is the inset light. This is another inset light. I just flipped it around the same way So it looks upwards instead of downwards, and they have the window, and then also the same exact inset lights, pillars, and then an inset wall similar to down there. So that's just the design that I was thinking about doing. I was just playing around with it, trying to figure it out, see what's worth back, see what works best, and this seemingly works okay. It does eat up a lot of interior plates though. So I use 25 interior plates just for one wall, which isn't too bad, but it's a pretty good chunk of interior plates though. So we're gonna probably design the whole entire base very similar to this. So each wall should have that, and then I could decide from there where I want to put everything else, like all of my refineries and assemblers and things like that. They can hang out more or less on the sides here. I kind of want to put it on the sides here, and then, you know, this could be just a window instead of an entrance. I don't know yet, but I feel like there's two ways I can go about this. It's put everything on the sides here, this side and this side, in terms of like cargo containers, everything like that. And just keep this entrance right there, this entryway and the back door here opened, so we can always fly in our ships and things like that. Well, it's more or less going to be small grid ships though. But do we even need to do that really? I don't know. I don't think so. It's not very important that we do it that way. We might as well kind of either leave it wide open like this to fly around, but is there a purpose to this? To flying around? Probably not. And then, of course, like I said before, we could always put some kind of stairwell and then chop these things up or create a hole so then we could make room within this asteroid here or this part of the asteroid. Potential ideas. We'll figure it out as we finish up the walls and everything like that. Then we could decide if we want to put things against it or not. But yeah, that was basically the idea. Weld. And then changing it up a little bit. I took a break from welding or putting up the walls and decided to make this thing here. So this thing here is going to be my traveling drill system or small grid ship, really, to get better resources such as silver, platinum, and gold. So that is the idea about getting this thing up and running. The only problem I have with this is that it is running off of ion thrusters without the large one, because this is a mimicked one from our welding ship. But our welding ship has the large ion thruster right here, which took 12 thruster components, which we don't have 12 with that one built out. So I put as much as I could, which is about 5 thruster components that were left after putting all the thrusters on here. I hope that is more than enough to push it forward, or at least stop. I guess we gotta stop a little bit early, because I realize I have a lot more over here than in the front. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 versus 5. So we might want to rebalance that out a little bit to be able to stop a little bit better when this thing gets full. So it's going to get full pretty quickly with material, but we're mainly going to gather the resources such as the gold, silver, platinum, things like that. And I put this medium cargo container, and I'm regretting it because putting more cargo space can make it even heavier and harder to move this thing, to be honest. I mean, I think we have enough thrust to move forward. It's just stopping is going to be a bit of a problem, although we could always spin it around and have it stop that way. But maybe I should actually do this instead. Put a sorter system here, link it up to the connector, and spit out all the stone that we're going to encounter later down the line, because we only want the important resources. So I might needing to do that, because I don't want to transport stone from asteroid to asteroid. So yeah, I think we're just going to replace that to a sorter and have it spit out the stone when we collect the stone. So I gotta remove that gyroscope and everything like that. Right now it's recharging, so that's why I haven't released it from this block right here. But basically, I took my large connector to small connector build here, so we can make these small grid ships and put a projector on it. So quick, easy thing to build with the welding arm as well, kind of like blueprint printing it out in a sense. and it's working out pretty okay. So we'll take this on the road in the next episode to find out gold, silver, or platinum, so we can get some more resources. And then we're going to finish up putting up the walls. So I hope you guys are still enjoying this series. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Drop a comment down below, even to just say hi. And of course, I'll see you guys next time. Bye.